different that I actually can't even make a traditional tier list for it. Why? Well, because nobody knows what the meta really looks like down there. While data miners have managed to collect a few Twitch clips and screenshots, for the most part, the Abyss is still a mystery. And this is because it's the only server in the game that's region locked. The pressure setting on this server is so high that it will easily one-shot any player trying to get into the Abyss. Conversely, the only way the Abyssal player base can survive there is by specking into extremely high internal pressure to counter it. But that means if they try to leave, they explode. Although there's not really any way to make a tier list for the Abyss, I can still discuss the strategies that are popular in the meta, and which abilities give you the best chance of success. You can pretty much just forget that the stealth stat even exists. There's no reason to waste any points on camouflage because there's no light down there. This is why every player there is just kill. Aesthetics, palette swaps, camouflage, all total waste of evolution points. Now, when I said there's no light, that isn't entirely true. There's no ambient light, but perhaps one of the most important abilities to learn how to use is bioluminescence. Over 90% of the player base uses this move, so mastering it is key to carving out a niche for yourself. One of the most common mistakes new players make is assuming that the best use of bioluminescence is to see. Make no mistake, trying to use bioluminescence as a flashlight in order to spot other players is easily the worst use of this ability. Bioluminescence won't help you find other players, but it will help other players find you. And so you need to be very position away to an enemy player. The best uses for this ability are to communicate and to loot. Communication is pretty self-explanatory. Use bioluminescence to talk to other players, signaling danger or finding other players to party up with. But perhaps the more infamous use of bioluminescence is infestate. Both Viperfish and Anglerfish are both prime examples of this, using their glow to attract other players in the vertical wind. Both are severely lacking in ability and rely on their trap in order to get their targets within the striking range, but make up for it with their ridiculous quiet. This can be a double-edged sword though, since if a more powerful player is nearby, you're still giving away your location. Most like throwing a flashbang or flare, somewhat similar to the Octopus' smoke screen. The other most important thing to know about the investment is how to survive in a server centered not around plants and herbivores, but around scavengers. Without light, no loot actually spawns down there, at least not in the form of plants. Luckily, there's no better area in the game to be a scavenger, because every elimination from the open ocean server leaves behind loot that falls to the Abyssal's. When no player gets defeated, it can turn the ocean floor into a year-long party, where players that would normally be enemies come to enjoy the event together. One major player that takes the show for these, but is rarely seen anywhere else, is the Sleeper Shark, which I think I should have used my shark now. Sleeper Sharks have the lowest mobility of any shark, and they've chosen to put their points into resistances, like pressure resistance, acid resistance, and temperature resistance. And unlike certain other extremophiles, these perks actually come in handy at the bottom of the ocean, especially near vents and volcanoes. Apparently this build has a great matchup against the Colossal Squid, but because neither the Colossal Squid nor Sleeper Shark have ever attended a major tournament, most players, myself included, have yet to see how on earth Sleeper Sharks can win that matchup. The last thing I want to highlight is the unmatched success of the Tumbler. It's found a way to tap into an infinite source of XP by making great use of the heat resistance perk you've got already uncontested control over one of the game's resources. Even Sleeper Sharks can't handle that level of heat, so these players can basically just farm as much XP as they want. Now, if someone were to come up with a predator build that resists the heat of the hyperbolic vent, and also be powerful enough to pierce the armor of the Tumbler, they could potentially get a really high score very quickly. So far, it's never been done, and so for now, Tumbler was pretty much the only thing. Now, one last thing you might notice is that none of these builds have any air. Is this because mammals can't really survive in the Abyss? Maybe. But it's also possible that the Abyssal community happens to be huge fans of Dollar Shave Club. Dollar Shave Club has everything you need to help you look and grow. My personal favorite is their Shave Butter. Dollar Shave Club is basically giving away their Daily Essentials starter set to new members for only $5. The starter set features three trial-sized versions of the most popular products that help you stay fresh and clean, along with their executive razor. And by taking advantage of this special offer, you'll actually be supporting my channel in the process. This $5 offer is available at dollarshaveclub.com/tierzoo.
That's 2. 1. Attack commencing. I am moving toward the payload.
Cash up top.
Large wave
Thank you, Mercy. I appreciate that.
Nicht. System restart initialized.
Come on, group up, guys.
Group up. Thank you, I'm ready.
Group up. I recommend hiding behind my back. You're not
getting away. Sorry, sorry.
Surrender.
No one is safe.
Get behind the barrier. Into the iris. You are advised to hide.
Dragon becomes.
Heroes never.
Oh,
do something.
Tactical visor activated. Target rich.
GG's.
Victory.
Easy clap. Alright, bye. It was fun.